Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, or welcome if you're new, it's Chi. Today I'm gonna be showing you guys what is inside of my everyday slash kind of work bag. I carry the Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the MM size. I should probably upgrade to the GM at this point, but I feel like the MM is still doing me justice. I'm just gonna take you guys through everything that I carry in this bag on a day-to-day basis, or for the most part on a day-to-day basis. Sometimes I do switch things up in here. I carry more, I carry less. When you see what's in here, you're gonna be like, how do you carry more? But it fits a lot, and I'm one of those people that if the bag is big, I will fit a crap ton of stuff into it. If that is something you guys wanna see, just keep watching. So this is my Neverfull MM. I have it in the Demiri Ben print with the red interior. And this is kind of an overview of what my bag looks like. I know that looks super packed in there, and it is. I'm gonna lower you guys down so you can see the bag, because I feel like that's super important. Every time I see a what's in my bag, I'm like, I wanna see the bag the entire time. So I'm gonna start taking you guys through what is inside of my Neverfull. So starting in the back, I have the little pouch that it actually comes with. I tend to use this for usually if I'm having a dinner or I'm going somewhere where I don't need to carry a big bag. I just use it as a clutch. It's very helpful. You can usually fit your phone, a lip gloss, maybe a card and some cash in here without it being too bulky. The next thing I have in here is my Louis Vuitton desk agenda. I do have a video on this planner and I'll have it linked below, so I'm not gonna go super in depth, but I picked this up a few months ago. It was kind of like my early graduation present, and I ended up graduating, so it served its purpose to motivate me. But I picked this up a few months ago, and I use this for financial planning. I have tabs at the top, and they're pretty simple tabs. They're income, expenses, savings, things like that. But yeah, again, I'll have the video where I go through the entire setup of this linked down below. The next thing I have is my Louis Vuitton agenda in the MM size, and this is the Demiri Ben print. I don't think I mentioned it, but this is the monogram print for the desk agenda. But this MM agenda is pretty much my everyday planner. I have all of the months of the year in here with a kind of dashboard in the front of all 2020. I cannot believe this year is almost over. I'm gonna have to switch out everything, but I pretty much use every single day. I mean, I love planning. It helps me stay super organized. I absolutely love this planner. The MM size is perfect for portability. You're able to take it with you without it being too big of a burden in your bag, but then there's also enough space in it for you to actually write out your thoughts and things that you need to do, as opposed to the PM size. And then if you want to see a super in-depth tour and plan with me, I'll have those linked below as well. The next thing I have is actually this 13 pocket little organizer. What I use this for, I don't know if you can see that, see if it'll focus. I actually use this for my receipts, my day-to-day receipts that come in just a simple paper form that you'll get at the grocery store, when you're out shopping, things like that. I tend to file my larger receipts and my kind of service receipts in a different type of setup. And here I have groceries, dining, shopping, personal care, cat care, gas, vehicle, services, office, and home improvement. So whenever I'm out shopping and I get a receipt, I will put it in the appropriate little slot. So if I go and pick up some, I don't know, Whataburger, I'll put it in dining. If I go to Staples to get any paper supplies, I'll put it in the office section, so on and so forth. This just helps me stay organized, and I do it by a month-to-month basis. So when October is over, I'll take out all the receipts, I'll kind of file them down to see how much I'm spending in each category, and then adjust my budget accordingly. The next thing I have in here is this pouch. I don't know where I got this from, to be completely honest. I've had it for so long, but I actually keep all my cords in here. I have a single charger in here with the base, just because I keep one in my car, but I like to bring a charger with me because you just never know when your phone's going to die. So yeah, I like to be prepared. And then I also have a set of earphones that are badly tangled, but they're still going strong. I haven't gotten AirPods. I'm still a part of the Wired crew, but I really don't care. I feel like I would lose AirPods. I don't know. And then I have these new earphones, and honestly, I thought they were the same as the ones I just showed you, but they're actually the, I guess the one that comes with the adapter instead of the little ear jack, just because I picked up a new phone for work. So I guess that new version of iPhone comes with that type of earphones. But you know, what do I know? I still have a 6 for my personal phone. The next thing I have in here is actually this little pencil pouch. I got this from Michaels. It's just super cute and super slim. I usually keep about 2 pens in here. Yeah, I have these little markers and pens in here. These pens I absolutely love. They're from True Red. I don't know if it'll focus, but they're from True Red, and I use either the 0.38 thickness or the 0.5 thickness. I love super thin pens. And then I have 3 of these markers. I color code everything inside of my MM agenda. The gray is for reminders, the pink is for events, and then the yellow/gold is for work. And I find that usually when I'm out and about and I need to jot things down, these are usually the 3 things that I'm like jotting down in my agenda, so I keep these to color code. The next thing I have in here is a mask. I just keep a black one in my purse, and then I keep like a blue one in my car, and I switch them out every so often. But yeah, you need a mask these days. The next thing I have in here is actually my sunglasses case. They say Ray-Bans on them, but I do not have Ray-Ban sunglasses in here. They're actually my Rebecca Minkoff sunglasses. These are my absolute favorite pair of sunglasses. They're just super oversized and aviator style. I feel like they look good on my face shape, so I keep these on me at all times, and I'm usually wearing gold, so it works out. Next thing I have in here, next 2 things I have in here actually, I have my 6-key ring holder. I don't really have a specific video about this just because it's an SLG, but I pretty much have all of my keys on here that I need. House key, mom's house key, my little clicker for my gate at my apartment, things like that. So yeah, I love this thing. I carry it around every single day because it has my keys, and it's just super handy. I don't know, it's the cutest SLG. The next thing is the infamous key clay, and I say infamous just because I feel like you can't really get your hands on these at the moment. I've been trying to buy a second one for a future giveaway, just, you know, hint hint, stay tuned to that. It might be a while, but I definitely want to give away a key clay in a future giveaway. So but I feel like right now it's super hard to just get your hands on. I have this in the monogram. I just love monogram in smaller items and items that tend to stay home or go inside of things, if that makes sense. So for like a big bag like this, I would stay away from large monograms. But I'm saying this now, but I have a bag in mind which has large monograms on it, but I'm just like, it's beautiful. But I just really like this little key clay. I have my daily cards in here, debit cards, insurance cards, cards that I pretty much need anytime I leave home, and then I have my car key attached to it. The next thing I have in here is one of my more recent purchases. It is my GM Cosmetics pouch. I do have a separate video on this in case you guys do want to see what I carry in here. Just as an overview, it is pretty stocked. I mean, I carry a bunch with me just because I like being prepared. Yeah, if you guys want to see a more in-depth tour of that, I'll have that video linked below. I'll pretty much link all of my Louis Vuitton-esque videos in case you guys are like, oh my God, I wanna see an in-depth tour of so-and-so. So yeah. The bag is looking fairly empty. The last 2 things I have in here are actually my phones, which sounds so weird to say. I feel like, why do you have 2 phones? I have an iPhone 6. I've had this since it actually came out. I don't even remember the year that the iPhone 6 came out, but I've had it since then. I'm just really good with my phones. I do have like 2 cracks or kind of lines you can't really see, but for the most part, I've never been one that loses their phone. I don't think I've ever lost a phone, quite honestly, or broken a phone. The second phone I have is actually the iPhone XR, and I picked this up a few days ago, and I actually got this for work. It has a separate number and a separate iCloud account just because I don't want those 2 things to mix. I found that it was beneficial to splurge and just buy the phone in full and have a separate business/work phone, just so that when I'm off, I can be off and just kind of relax and hang out and chill and not be getting work text messages when I'm off or on vacation. So yeah, and I have service on both of them. I actually got a good deal at T-Mobile. I pay $50 for 2 phones. So yeah, I'm just throwing that out there in case you are watching and you are someone who works and uses your phone a lot for work, but you're thinking about kind of getting a separate line. I got a good deal at T-Mobile for $50 for 2 lines. So definitely check that out if you guys are thinking about getting a new phone. But yeah. Yeah, guys, that is everything from inside of my bag. It is empty. Nothing was left. I know someone's probably like, oh my God, she's so rough with her bag. But you know what? Bags like this are meant to be used. They're meant to be broken in. They're meant to be taken around the town, and you can even take them to work. Like I use my bags. Whether the bag was $50 or $2,000, I'm going to use the bag. There's no point in me buying a luxury bag or any kind of bag just to like stare at it. So yes, I tend to be a little rough with my bag, but I think I've had this bag for almost a year and it still looks brand new. This is the bottom and there's no feet. Sadly, I wish there was feet. I feel like so many people use this bag for work and travel. It would do good with some feet. But yeah, that is everything in my Neverfull. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to leave any other suggestions you guys wanna see in the future. I did take a poll on my channel and I know that the Louis Vuitton video won, but I'm still gonna do a fridge tour and show you guys what's in my fridge and freezer just because I love watching those. So I figured why not show you guys what I keep in mind. But yeah, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Also subscribe and join the growing family. We're actually at 1,000, that's super cool. But yeah, I will talk to you guys in my next one. Bye.